Hello students, I welcome you once again to the e-learning sessions of LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Myself, Hardik Shah, and I am here to share my knowledge with you all about the subject of automotive electricals and electronics. Okay, we are starting a new chapter today, that is ignition systems in automobile. Okay, and today we will discuss about the different types of ignition systems like battery ignition and magneto ignition system. Okay. I hope you will see this video till the end to completely understand this topic and gain your skills in automotive engineering. Okay, so if you have any query, you can ask me it in comment section. I will try to solve all the queries as soon as possible. Okay, and also take a note of the important things. So now let's start our today's video. So today we will discuss about the three things. First is introduction to the ignition systems, second ignition system types, and third one, that is the electronic ignition system, if it is there. Okay, so let's see first the introduction to the ignition systems. Now, as we know that in the case of the internal combustion engines, that is IC engines, combustion of the air and the fuel takes place in a side, the engine cylinder and the product of the combustion expand to the produce reciprocating motion of the piston. Okay, now this reciprocating motion of the piston is in turn converted into the rotary motion of the crankshaft through connecting rod and crank. Okay, now this rotary motion of the crankshaft is in turn used to drive the generators for generating the power. Okay, so this was about the ignition system. We also know that there are four cycles of operation, okay, which are suction, compression, power generation and the exhaust. Okay, now these you can say operations are performed either during the two strokes of the piston or during the four strokes of the piston. Okay, and accordingly they are called as a two stroke cycle engines and four stroke cycle engines. Okay, now in the case of the petrol engines, during the suction operation, charge of the air and the petrol fuel will be taken in. Okay, so during the compression, this charge is compressed by the upward moving piston. Okay, and just before the end of the compression, the charge of the air and the petrol fuel will be ignited by means of the spark produced by means of the spark plug. Okay, so the and also the ignition system does function of producing the spark in the case of spark ignition engines also, that means SI engines. Okay, and spark plugs which are used with petrol engines mainly consist of the central electrode and a metal tongue. Okay, now central electrode is covered by means of the porcelain insulating material, so voltage does not get out. Okay, now through the metal screw, the spark plug is fitted in the cylinder head plug. Okay, now when the high tension voltage of the order of 30,000 volt or more is applied across the spark electrodes, current jumps from the one electrode to another producing a spark. Fine. Now whereas in the case of diesel engines, that means compression ignition CI engines, okay, only air is taken in during the suction operation and in compression during the compression operation, and just before the end of the compression, when the diesel fuel is injected, it gets ignited due to the heat of the compression of the air. Okay, now once the charge is ignited, combustion starts and products of the combustion expand, that is they force the piston to move downwards, that is they produce the power, and after producing the power, the gases are actually exhausted during the exhaust operation. Now, so this was all basics about the ignition systems. Okay, so now let's see different types of ignition system. Okay, basically conventional ignition systems are of the two types. First is battery, or you can say coil ignition system, and the second is magneto ignition system. Okay, so what is that? So both of these are actually conventional methods. Okay, and ignition systems works on mutual electromagnetic induction principle. Okay, I repeat, it is mutual electromagnetic induction principle. Now, battery ignition system was generally used in a four-wheelers, but nowadays it is more commonly used in two-wheeler also. Okay, that is button start two-wheelers like Pulsar, Kinetic Honda, Activa, Scooty, etc. Okay, now in this case, 6-volt or 12-volt battery will supply necessary current in the primary winding. Okay, so in primary winding, it will supply the current. In magneto ignition system, it is mainly used in a two-wheelers for kickstart engines. Okay, for example, Bajaj scooters, thereafter Splendor, Passion. Okay, now in this case, magneto will produce and supply current to the primary winding. Okay, so in magneto ignition system, magneto replaces the battery. Simple one. Okay, so this was all about the simple difference between the battery and magneto. So let's see first what is battery ignition system in detail. Here the figure shows the diagram of the battery ignition system for the four cylinder petrol engine. Okay, it mainly consists of the 6 or 12 volt battery. Okay, it has a high ampere ignition switch, auto transformer, contact breaker, capacitor, distributor rotor, thereafter distributor contact points, spark plugs, etc. So these are all the components inside this figure. Okay, now you need to note that that figure shows the ignition system for the four cylinder petrol engine. So here there are four spark plugs and contact breaker. Cam has a four corners. Okay, number of spark plug equal to number of corners. Okay, now if it is 6-cylinder engine, then it will have 6 spark plug and contact breaker cam will be a perfect hexagon, means it will have 6 corners. Okay, now the ignition system is divided into two circuits. First, it is primary circuit. Second is secondary circuit. Okay, now in primary circuit, it consists of the 6 or 12 volt battery, emitter, ignition switch, primary winding. It has 200 to 300 turns of the 20 sharp wire gauge, that is SWG gauge, wire, contact breaker and the capacitor. Okay, in a secondary circuit, it consists of the secondary winding, that is secondary winding consists of about 21,000 turns of the 40 gauge wire. Okay, bottom end of which is connected to the bottom end of the primary and top end of the secondary winding is connected to the center of the distributor rotor. Fine, so distributor rotor rotates and make contacts with contact point and they are connected to the spark plug which are fitted in cylinder heads. Okay, now let's see the working of it. So what is the working? When the ignition switch is closed and engine is cranked, as soon as the contact breaker closes, a low voltage current will flow through the primary winding. Okay, it is also to be noted that the contact breaker cam opens and closes the circuit 4 times because there are 4 cylinders and 4 problem. Okay, in one revolution. Now when the contact breaker opens the contact, the magnetic field begins to collapse. Okay, now because of this collapsing magnetic field, current will be induced in a secondary winding. That means whenever contact breaks, current will flow through the secondary winding. Now, and because of more turns, that means it has 21,000 turns of secondary, the voltage goes up to 20 to 30,000 volt increasing. Okay, now this is high voltage current, so it is brought to center of the distributor rotor. Now distributor rotor rotates and supply this high voltage current to the proper spark plug depending upon the engine firing order. Now when the high voltage current jumps the spark plug gap, it produces a spark and the charge which is inside the engine is ignited. Thereafter combustion starts, it products of the combustion expands and it produces power. Now note here some important points, like the function of the capacitor is actually to reduce the arcing at the contact breaker because they are connecting very frequently. Okay, this is contact breaker points. Also, when the contact breaker opens, the magnetic field is in the primary winding begins to collapse. When the magnetic field is collapsing, capacitor gets fully charged and then it starts discharging. Okay, and helps in building up the voltage in the secondary winding. So capacitor plays important role because of that. Second is contact breaker cam and distributor rotors are mounted on a same shaft, okay, in two stroke engines. These are motored at the same engine speed, and in four stroke cycle engines, they are motored at the half of the engine speed, okay. So this was all about the battery ignition systems, okay. Next is magneto ignition system. So what is that? So in this case of the magneto, will produce and supply the required current to the primary winding, okay. Now in this case, as shown here, we can have rotating magneto with a fixed coil or rotating coil with a fixed magneto, means one is rotor, one is stator, okay, for producing and supplying the current to the primary, okay. Now remaining arrangement is same as that of the battery ignition systems. So it was all about the magneto system. It has only two part different. One is rotating field, one is steady magneto, okay. So we discuss about the different ignition systems today. I wish you got the clear idea about this. Therefore, if you have any more to know or you have any specific query, let me know. I will surely try to respond as soon as possible. Okay. I hope you like this video. Thank you so much. Stay tuned. Goodbye.